This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. Recently, temperatures dipped below freezing and snow blanketed our area a bit, but it wasn't long ago that we were experiencing spring-like conditions. While most of us enjoyed those warm days, Pocono businesses took quite a hit. Alice Massimi has more.
Wonderland. The Pocono Mountains, full of snowy hillsides, swooshing skiers, and the inspiration for the well-known song, Winter Wonderland.
Well, in the meadow, we can build a snowman.
We have skiing, we have snowmobiling, we have ice skating, we have cross-country skiing, we have hunting in the winter, fishing, ice fishing. So we have a number of winter activities. And actually, a lot of people just come up to go sleigh riding in some of the resorts.
The only problem? This year, there's barely any snow. It's the beginning of February, but it seems like winter's just starting. Good news for those of us who don't like winter, but not for the 18,000 people in the tourism industry. They rely on the white stuff.
Well, it's been slow. Martin Luther King, we were off substantially, maybe 75% for that weekend. I think year to date, we're off about 50%.
Camelback has been making snow around the clock since the season began, but they just haven't been able to get ahead.
We had 9 trails, I believe, open from when we started, and unfortunately, we stayed with those 9 because we'd make snow and then it would melt, and then we'd make snow on the same trails and it would melt. But we managed to stay open.
Normally, there are 33 slopes open at Camelback by now. This year, they've only been able to open 18. But that's fine with these skiers and snowboarders. They say they'll make the best with what they've got.
Go out every day that I can, regardless, whether it's a sheet of ice, whether it's fresh powder, whether it's packed powder, groomed. Gotta just make the best of what you got and have fun.
PJ Valenza and Jessica Bailey like to hit the trails 3 to 4 times a week. But this season, they say that hasn't been possible.
Today is like the nicest I've been, that I've seen in a while, actually. So, pretty excited.
The season got started off pretty late this season, just because Mother Nature is not giving us any loving right now. With what she's given us, they're working with it pretty hard. So, it's not as good as it was at this time last year, but they're doing the best they can with it. So.
Brian Forsyth, who came in from Staten Island, is also making the most of the lackluster season. He actually likes the empty slopes.
Well, the slopes are a little less crowded. You get to, you know, if you make a mistake, you're not going to bounce into somebody. But it was definitely enjoyable.
On average, the Poconos gets close to 60 inches of snow a year. But this season, almost all of the snow you see is man-made.
We have 2,400 square miles here in the counties of Carbon, Monroe, Pike, and Wayne. Very hard to make snow all over 2,400 square miles. In fact, it's impossible. So we need Mother Nature to do that.
Not only are the slopes hurting, every place from gas stations to restaurants to hotels are praying for snow.
Business at some of these places has been non-existent, not just down, but no business.
Good morning. Thanks for calling the Chateau and Resort Conference Center. This is Billy speaking. How may I direct your call?
The Chateau in Tannersville, usually booked solid this time of year, only has 75% of their rooms occupied.
We're now having our warmest season on record for many, many years. So business has been a little slower than we anticipated.
Yet Andrews is keeping her spirits up. She says the snow has to come sooner or later. Historically, February is the Poconos' busiest month, and she's hoping it comes sooner. So do the folks at Camelback. They're offering deals throughout the month and making as much snow as they can. But even if the snow does come, December and much of January is a total wash for businesses.
So we really can't make up a lot of business we lost in January. The time period we may be able to make some business up is March. But we shall see how old man winter arrives or doesn't arrive in March also.
A gamble many don't want to take. So they're looking towards next year and the year after that, realizing it's not safe to bank on a winter wonderland. Everyone's got a backup plan. Camelback built a water park, and the Chateau's advertising is aimed at the business traveler.
We've just finished a more than $3 million renovation in our building. We have over 14,000 square feet of meeting space, including a 92-seat lecture hall that's just magnificent.
Spas and indoor water parks are popping up, and so are other businesses that don't depend on the weather. But until they create an indoor ski resort, you'll just have to get used to being at the mercy of old man winter. For Tempo, I'm Alice Massimi reporting.